Now I will discuss architecture of Unix. What is general architecture of Unix? If you follow the different books, there are different kind of architecture. But the basic, for the basic understanding, this is good. Okay. So, in a first rectangle, there is a hardware. And the, again, in the next, this is the kernel. And next, this is a shell. And next, this is a application software. And next, this is a user. So now, explain one by one. What is the meaning of hardware actually? So just tell me, what is the meaning of hardware? Any one of them? Okay. So what is the meaning of hardware? Hardware is nothing. Hardware is a physical component of your computer. If you see the RAM, if you see the processor, if you see the register, all of them are physical components of your computer. So, but you can't work with physical component directly. So you can't work with physical component directly. This is the basic problem of normal user. So definitely, but all the works has been done by a hardware. Definitely you have to. So hardware is just like your physical component. Our body physical component is our hardware. But our, if you see the, our brain, our thought, our imagination, this is the software part. So this is a hardware. And just above the hardware, there is kernel. What is the meaning of kernel? Kernel is a heart of your operating system actually. Operating system has a lot of components where kernel is a heart of operating system. What is the working of kernel? Kernel performs all low level activity. So kernel performs all low level work. Just like it's deal with hardware actually. So it deals with hardware. What is the meaning it's deal with hardware? Actually, you don't know where your memory has space, which sector is memory is empty, which sector of memory is full. But the operating system knows which sector of memory is empty and which sector of memory is full. So you give the instruction to operating system to store your file, and operating system knows where this file will be placed, where the space of memory is available, and operating system puts this into the that empty place. So this is the working of your kernel. And if you see the file management process scheduling, deadlock handling, all our activities performed by a kernel. So this is the basic functionality of kernel. But the user can't directly interact with the kernel actually. This is the basic fundamental. You have to remember. Just in above level, there is a name is called shell. In Unix and Linux, this is very, very important. In Unix, I am saying again, in Unix and in Linux, shell is very important, and for the advanced courses you have to learn what is the working of shell actually. So what is shell? Shell, I am giving a one line definition. Shell is a collection of command which is placed in one place is your computer. This is called shell. So what is shell? Collection of commands which is placed in one place. This is called shell. Okay. So like cat cd command, cat command, mkdir command, and it has a lot of commands. First of all, if you see Linux basically launched with graphical user interface, graphical based interface, GUI. But if you see the Unix, it has launched with command based user interface. command-based user interface. What is the difference between the command-based user interface and graphical user interface? Suppose, if you want to open your file, but by a command you can do, or directly with the help of mouse you can open a file. So this is the basic difference between the command-based user interface or graphical user interface. So with the help of graphics I can do any task, with the help of terminal and typing the command I can do any task. So this is the basic functionality of Unix. But nowadays Unix has also the graphical user interface and the Linux has also a command based user interface. So this is the basic difference between the command based interface and the graphical user interface. So now come to the cell. If you see, in every Linux and Unix system there is a cell. What is a cell? You can call it like a terminal. So there is a terminal. So terminal, what is the basic functionality of terminal? Terminal execute your command and perform your task. So the shell actually deal with kernel directly. So your command is placed here, and thus just these commands is deal with kernel, and kernel deal with hardware, and your task has been done. So this is the basic functionality of shell. Come to the next word is next bracket. This is there is a word application software. So all of you know about the application software, and there are a lot of application software like the if you see the Windows, MS Word, browser, and this is all of them are application software. So if you see application software, browsers, office, in Linux there is a Libero Office, all are application software. And above the application software there is a user. So all of them, we and you, all of them, we are just user. So what is the meaning of user? User is a normal user. I am a user and you are a user. All human beings just like a user deal with application software or command prompt. Application software on command prompt deals with kernel, and kernel deals with hardware. So this is the general structure and general architecture of Unix.